We slept with y'all in the bed. Mm-hmm. The next day, she wasn't there. She left. But only thing about that, when she wasn't there, my laptop was gone. My wallet was gone.
And, you know, she came over, she spent the night. But let me ask you, do you know if she was involved in any type of drug activity before this? Before you, I mean, I know it happened that day, but she gave you no kind of preference to let you know that anything was going on?
Wait. This can't be. No. This is like the trace of a crackhead. And I know she ain't on that stuff. Because I know her from back in the day.
You know, based on what you're telling me,
yeah.
You know, I'm just trying to figure out what prompted her to do that. I mean, whether she was in a financial crisis or just felt like doing it to hurt you. I mean, sometimes people steal from you, not because they have the need of money, but just to hurt you.
I don't think she did it to hurt me.
You will be praying for me, but it'd be behind bars, on a life sentence, or on a life sentence going to death row, because that's where I was at. I had to really contemplate, I had to really meditate, I had to really think about what I was about to do. It's like saying, think about before you think. Think about what you're going to do. So I'm like, oh my Lord, I don't know what to do. My head is spinning, so please. You're a woman of prayer. You're a praying woman. You prayed for me when I was a kid in Sunday school, when I was acting up with my friends. So give me some advice. Let me know, what should I do? Yes, indeed.
Did you
talk
to Jesus?
Come on, Sister Gladys. You know I'm not like that. I mean,
if you're gonna talk to somebody about your problem, talk to somebody who can do something about it. Friends and family can't do nothing about this.